This isn't the result I was hoping for, Jim.
Ah, it's not it. Not the one.
Game over.
And
your previously saved game.
Spock's dead.
I would not recommend removing the canister without turning off the valve.
Oh, that makes sense. We can move it with the anti-grav unit as well. Okay, I don't know why I didn't think of that.
Gas feed is off.
Okay.
You attach the anti-grav unit to the gas tank. It can be moved freely.
Okay, I'm not sure which one was supposed to be messing with here, but...
You install the gas tank to the synthesizer's feed lines. Gas feed is on.
Okay, let's mess with stuff. Put this here. And press this.
The machine synthesizes a quantity of inert matter.
This does not appear to provide us with anything useful, Spock says. Although somehow he said it completely silently. Okay, so I'm guessing we want the N2 and the H2. N2 and H2. Okay, let's turn the thing off again. Not sure how close Spock is to dying.
Gas feed is off.
Let's take the O2 out.
You attach the anti-grav unit to the gas tank. It can be moved freely.
And put the H2 there.
Nothing happens.
What do you mean nothing happens? Excuse me. Which one did he want again? The O2?
Nothing happens. You install the gas tank to the synthesizer's feed lines.
Is that a different sound than before? That might be a victory sound. Wait. Oh, I don't... is wasting valuable time. I know the computer in there probably tells us what we need. I'm hoping we can get more of this crap.
You grab a handful of insulation.
We sure do. Let's get the hell back here. Not sure if we're gonna make it now. This here.
You have distilled a quantity of polybaryl carbonate.
Back in here. This in here.
Nothing happens.
Nothing. Oh, the gas isn't on. Getting complicated here.
Gas feed is on.
Fascinating, Captain.
I don't want to use the wrench on that. Bach is ready to keel over any second.
The machine synthesizes a quantity of inert matter.
Okay, so is that the one I did before? So O2 and N2 is no good. I don't think we're gonna make it. I'm not sure which one I did. I should have been keeping track here. This in here.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. Oh,
nothing happens.
I didn't turn the feedback on.
Gas feed is on.
Did you just do it automatically?
The machine synthesizes a quantity of inert matter.
So, I don't know which one we need. But we don't want to put... We don't want to put that in there. Do I have enough time to run back and grab more insulation? Maybe I put the insulation there?
You grab a handful.
All I know is this is driving me crazy, right? We are crazy. Crazy. Okay, what if I take... Well, first of all, take this out.
You take the Ouroboros.
I do. And then I put... This here.
You have distilled a quantity.
I put this here.
That's for virus cultures only, Jim.
Virus cultures only, Jim. So take this out.
Done.
And put this... Where is it? Here.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Alright, it's not supposed to go there. So... I really don't know. Unless we're just supposed to add water to this. Just driving me insane.
Gas feed is off.
Take the N2.
You attach the anti-grav.
Put the O2 back.
You install the gas tank to the synthesizer.
And then... Turn it on.
Gas feed is on.
And then... Put... Where is it? Oh, it's back in the other room. Damn it! Damn it, Jim! No. Where'd it go? It is there. Alright, back through. I don't know why I didn't see it. This in here. Play with this.
The machine synthesizes 1 liter of TLTDH gas.
An unusual compound.
Take this.
You take a 1 liter container of TLTDH gas. You fail to obtain anything.
I'm not trying to obtain stuff. I want to go through here. Have I tried this already?
You take the Ouroboros virus culture.
And that just makes him take it out again. I think I've done this before with McCoy.
Nothing happens.
I want to put it in there.
Captain, I believe Dr. McCoy has the necessary...
Okay, McCoy...
Captain, I believe...
I thought I was selecting McCoy. That's McCoy.
Game over.
And now he's dead.
Previously saved game.
Okay. It was saying here that you can make ammonia. Ammonia is HN3, I think NH3 it said. So if I get the hydrogen and the nitrogen here, I can make ammonia. So maybe we want to make ammonia.
I would not recommend removing.
Oh god. Everything's so manual.
Gas feed is off.
Okay. I mean, we really don't have time, Spock. We should just be doing this automatically.
Nothing happens.
Oh god.
Nothing happens.
Come on.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Are you serious? Move him away from there. Get it.
You attach the anti-gra-
Thank you. the N we want here.
Nothing happens. You install the gas tank to the-
I sure do.
Gas feed is on.
Okay, so with nothing attached, nothing in here anyway, might combine the two gases.
The machine synthesizes a liter of-
I hope you don't want me to swap the deck with that, Captain.
I think we can set this aside and not worry about it.
Oh, we probably need it for something.
This is the door to the synthesis chamber.
In principle, Captain, this-
Next you'll tell us, compare- I rest my case.
Let's just get our stuff.
You take a 1 liter container of ammonia.
This is the ammonia?
This blue-gray container holds 1 liter of ammonia.
Okay, I have an idea to... maybe mess with this. Let's take the water out.
Done.
Done. Let's put the ammonia in.
A loud hissing fills the room.
Hissing is filling the room.
We have to attach something to the nozzle first.
I didn't want to leave the room. Come on. Out. And why is hissing filling the room? I was just putting that in there. Holy crap, we don't have it. I guess I messed something up.
Save new game.
Hell no. No. Can I quit out? Quit out? Thank you. I want to load. We're gonna do this all over again. What did I mess up? Alright, guys, I'm gonna do all this crap over again, and yeah, see you on the other side. Okay, this time hissing didn't fill the room. I would prefer it if Bones handled this, as usual.
Eureka, this is it, Jim. There's not much, but all I need to do is synthesize some more, and we're in business.
In business? Okay, can I take this thing?
You retrieve the Ouroboros cure sample.
Okay, can I just give this to him? Let's look. Look.
This is Dr. McCoy's cure for the Ouroboros toxin.
Nope, okay. Let's just take it.
Jim, we need to synthesize more to make that serum before we can use it.
Okay. Alright, do I go in here for that? With more ammonia? Is that right? What the hell is this?
This is the door to the synthesis chamber.
In principle,
I don't want to look at the
to many
door.
Rest of my case.
Shut up.
You fail to obtain anything.
Well, of course, it's so friggin' small. Thank you.
You take the hypo with Ouroboros toxin cure.
Okay, good. Good.
This is Dr. McCoy's cure for the Ouroboros toxin in a hypo.
I know I'm really pressing my luck here. Can he analyze it? No. Let's just give it to him. Oh, he'll give it to him.
There. You're now cured.
Thank you, Doctor.
Finally, a human response.
Huh. Raises an eyebrow. Okay, so finally we're off this timer, possibly? We have all this crap now.
He's been cured of the Ouroboros virus.
Nice. And we still have the hypo, right? Do we? Yes, we do. Sorry, guys. Now let's go downstairs. Downstairs. Now we can let these guys free, like we should. Ray.
Thank God it's you, Jim. I'm.
It's about time.
Thank you for saving our. Thank you for saving our station.
That's all you have to say. Alright, let's go. Let's see if we can cure this guy. See if Bones has anything to say.
Damn it, Jim, I'm a doctor, not a diplomat.
The Romulan Preax stirs weakly, then begins to get up. He has been cured.
He's severely dehydrated, but he'll live.
Please don't try to kill us.
This Romulan commander is cautiously looking at you.
Oh, we can't even examine him now?
Nothing to report, Captain.
Yeah.
I have called off the Romulan attack on this station, Kirk. I believed your virus was some kind of deliberate attack, but your great honor and compassion have convinced me otherwise.
You also conducted yourself in the most honorable fashion, Centurion Preax. You may return to Romulan space without Federation interference. I assure you, the Federation would never undertake such a foul program. It was all an accident, right, Dr. Marcus? Save it for someone who's buying Preax. Leave Federation space immediately or we'll scatter your atoms across the quadrant.
Ah, the kick-ass Kirk.
You also conducted yourself in the most honorable fashion, Centurion Preax.
Not really.
You may return to Romulan. I assure you, the Federation would never undertake such a foul program.
Absolutely. We've already destroyed all cultures and purged the data files. This will never happen again.
You are an honorable adversary, Kirk. Jolan True.
You are also a worthy opponent, Preax. May you live long and prosper.
Spock raises an eyebrow. Endure, Preax, etc. In enduring, grow strong.
You'll never cease to amaze me, Jim.
Goodbye, Carol.
Goodbye, Jim.
Well, gentlemen, let's go home.
Hey, I wanted to wake up the other Vulcans.
Message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have read your report on the problems at Arc 7 and evaluate your performance at 65%. You and your crew received 1 commendation points. A satisfactory performance, Captain, but there's still room for improvement.
I'm gonna fix it.
I wonder if I'll see Captain.
Okay, let's cure all these guys and see if we can get somewhat higher at least than a 65%.
The Romulans stir weakly, then begin to get up. They've all been cured.
They're severely dehydrated, but they'll live. We got to them in time.
This Romulan is groggy, but conscious. This Romulan is groggy. This Romulan is...
They're all groggy, but conscious.
This Romulan is...
Got it.
The Romulans have been cured of the Ouroboros virus, but they're severely dehydrated and need some rest.
Okay, now we'll let these guys go.
Thank God, it's you, Jim.
It's about time someone got here.
Thank you for saving our station, Jim.
No, maybe because I didn't look at this stuff.
An odd-looking device, almost like a 20th century torpedo fitted with...
My God, that's some kind of weapon.
Everyone on this project is an avowed pacifist, Doctor.
Some odd-looking equipment connected to the torpedo.
What does this stuff do? What's going on here?
We're conducting research into the origins of life in the universe. This is our equipment.
This Romulan commander is unconscious. This is a very advanced research laboratory.
I know. I think you get points for having, you know, looking at stuff and having Spock analyze stuff and everything.
Nothing to report, Captain. Fascinating. This device contains over 10 million forms of life. Patterns I have never seen before.
We call this the cradle, Mr. Spock.
I detect no other life forms in the room, Captain.
They've been through a good deal of stress. He's infected with the virus too, Jim. There's nothing there requiring...
Okay, let's bring this guy back. Back to life.
The Romulan Preax stirs weakly, then begins to get up.
He's severely dehydrated, but he'll...
live.
They've been through a good deal.
Weird how it doesn't work on him.
This Romulan commander is...
He's already cured, Jim.
Yeah.
Why would you want to do that?
Anything else we can do?
That's not working, Jim.
I want to tug him around.
That's not working, Jim.
Nothing happens.
Want some O2?
That's not working, Jim.
Nothing happens.
How about some water?
The Romulan Preax drinks thirstily and empties the container.
Take it easy now. You'll feel better in a few minutes. Good thing we had the water available, Jim.
We aren't barbarians, in spite of what some might think.
Pretty cool. That might give us even more points.
This Romulan...
I have called off the Romulan attack on this station, Kirk. I believed your virus was some kind of deliberate attack, but your great honor and compassion have convinced me otherwise.
You also conducted yourself in the most honorable fashion since your... I assure you, the Federation would never undertake such...
Absolutely. We've already destroyed all cultures and purged the data files. This will never happen again.
You are an honorable adversary, Kirk. Jolan Tru.
Jolan Tru.
You are also a worthy opponent, Preax. May you live long and prosper.
You'll never cease to amaze me, Jim.
Goodbye, Carol.
Goodbye, Jim.
Well, gentlemen, let's go home.
For the beam up.
Message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have read your report on the problems at Arc 7.
Ah, a little
and
better.
And evaluate your performance at 72%.
What are we going to say?
You and your crew receive 2 commendation points. Well done, Captain. Keep up the good work.
I wonder if I'll see Carol again.
Well, if you don't, you can always drown your sorrow in some Romulan ale.
That's illegal, Bones.
Tell that to the Romulans, Jim. I found a whole case they brought on board, the Arc 7.
They'll never replace Scotch, Captain.
That is all, Mr. Scott.
I wonder what we could have done differently. Maybe if we'd gone and synthesized water and gave it to all of them?
Another fine mess.
Oh, another fine mess you've gotten us in, Jim.
Priority message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have reports of an undetermined number of Elasi pirate ships in your sector.
Oh,
you are ordered to proceed to the Harlequin star system immediately and investigate. Starfleet out.
Okay, and that'll be it for this episode. Stay tuned for the next episode when we play another fine mess. Endure and live long and prosper.